Goddamn. I need a drink.
Son of a bitch! Give me a drink. One more night. I just can't fit me. Son of a bitch! If I can't get clean, I'm gonna drink my life away.
Cheers. And,
can we turn this light off and clear on my freaking head is...
Sorry, that's on.
Like, that's blinding.
Sorry, that one wasn't even supposed to be on. That was just because I was working on a Crate Club video. What do I have to declare? You know, I'm going to have to look up those four items. The Crate Club is $199 a month. So, we can say it here. It's $200. And, I know the Zippo hand warmer's almost $100. I can only imagine that tire inflator has to be up there, but the one thing I have not had a chance to try at all. I've turned the tire inflator
on. Is that
on,
Bluetooth, but, by the way?
No, it actually creates its own Wi-Fi. So you search for this network.
It's basically like my dash cam then.
So, but I have not tried it. Now, some people say, well, who needs that? One thing I don't know, and it doesn't say it in the paperwork, is if you can record while you're doing it, because I haven't downloaded the app yet. But what is cool is if you're by yourself, or even if you are with, you could have this sitting on the table or somewhere else. I don't know what the range is, but you don't have to keep looking through this to acquire your image. You just look at your damn phone. So you literally could take a shot and look down at your phone and see where you hit. But. You know, it's always much funnier, Miles, when I did it. You know what I think? And then I got Greggy Poo. He's like, "Do you just fart?" And I go, "I proudly announce all of them."
You know what you do? You take and you fart by him. If it's quiet, when you be like, "Do you smell popcorn?" Just watch him get a big old freaking whiff of that and watch him throw up.
Look on his face if I drop.
Case for a fucking ass.
If I drop this. Oh, perfect. Toppling Goliath Timber, barreled aged stout.
Toppling Timber.
You don't even want to know how much.
You don't want to know.
This, you don't want to know. You don't want to know. How much.
We'll let you know if you want to buy it, though.
This bottle costs. Hey, well, he's not going to watch this, but Johnny Watson or NIHAP. Remember that bottle we split all those years ago? This one, which is smaller, was the same price.
Okay, so first
I have to not cut myself.
First you have to wax off.
Oh, it's the crackle kind.
Hey, even we're going to put that back on the bottle, it's going to go into your collection.
And the hood. And we both decided that if we're going to open this, we have to open it with an awesome bottle opener. So we are going to open it with the Hornet Fixer. This will be my first attempt on this with this guy, by the way. Looks like it's trans-angled. Just trying to make as little damage to the bottle as possible. Thank you, Jim. It went swimmingly. You want to do the honors, and I'll read a couple of questions, comments, a couple of questions. First in was Clyde. It's Clyde. Clyde is first saying second, so either somebody got deleted, or he beat cold-hearted bastard and didn't realize it. Then Clyde says, "Well, maybe not," and Cobra is just laughing. It's a lot funnier when the comments, evidently comments have been deleted. Gunwild says, yo. Clyde says, whiskey and revolution for all. And then Clyde says, J-Dog in the house. Rich Huff says, cheers all. Merry Christmas, too.
Are you ready?
No. Well, I can tell you one thing.
Flashlight test.
I don't know if that's even necessary. I'm just by looking at how much it is lighting up.
That's tradition.
Yeah, I gotta do this for the dark one. Besides that, this is the cool glass. So we got gym mode, firefly, low, medium, high, and turbo. And that is coming around the glass and not making it through the glass. Just look at that stuff.
Turn out the lights in here when you do that.
That's just how cool etched glass is. And speaking of that, that did get turned on.
Oh, it did get turned on.
It is turned on.
It's red. That's not good. That's the sign of soon to be dead red. You know what this smells like? It smells a lot like
molasses.
Well, it smells like a bent paddle, double black, but it's bringing,
oh my god,
a lot higher level of oh my god with it. Okay, cheers.
If I had to choose between this and sex with my wife, I'd choose this.
I've had sex with your wife, and this is probably a little better. Wow, that is like
if I spilled any of this, I would lick it off the fucking floor. We should almost invite Matt over for some of this.
No. Hey, Matt.
Whoa. It's almost got a liquor quality to it.
This might be one of the heaviest mouthfeels.
Yeah, it's almost, it not only has, do you taste like molasses in it?
Yeah.
And almost, it's very, very, very thick.
Wow. It has a, here's what, I'm actually getting stumped by this one. I'm getting that molasses, that like sugar, that thick sugar molasses. And here's the strange thing. Even though I envision that I'm drinking like straight syrup molasses, it's somehow, it's not ultra sweet.
Yeah. You get a nice burn on it.
15.4.
15.4%. Worth all the pain.
Clyde says, Merry Christmas to y'all. Merry Christmas, Clyde, and everyone else. Cold Hearted Bastard says, Merry Christmas, everyone.
So that costs almost as much as two bottles of Bumbu.
Wow. Nice segue. Speaking of Bumbu, Miles.
Is that really a secure location for something so precious?
But wait,
there's more. Hey, come on, when the kit with the two glasses in it is on sale for the same price as a bottle?
No, no kidding. It's like,
hang on, here, you just hold the box. I'm gonna hold it on the table.
Glue it in there.
Here, grab the glass.
We saved the free glasses and then dropped the frickin' Bumbu.
Oh, fuck. So now we have six glasses like that.
Talking about the recycling. Would you like to stick it in?
harder.
No, that's okay.
And here's the funny thing. Is some of the stouts we've had here, when I burp, I get everything coming back up. I don't have anything in this. It's like it's so heavy, it's staying down. Yeah, and here's the other thing, is they have a sign on there that the biggest print is limit 2 bottles per customer for the Toppling Goliath. Shall we score that right away, Eric?
How many was there?
There was like 5 there, or 6.
I was going to say, I saw that sign that said that you could only buy 2, and I'm like, look, I'm looking at the shelf going, there's a jack shit. Do we really need to come up with a score for this?
11.
I won't argue with you. This is
an 11.
Now that bottle. See, now here's the thing. I think I would enjoy having another glass of this. Now that bottle that me, Johnny, and Nyhap shared. I was more than happy to be done with the first one. It was so rich, and so over the top. It was like, okay, I can say that I had some of it,
mm-hmm.
but do I? That was that Speedway, that dude said, you'll never have this. The one that you have is the regular one. You have to have the golden ticket, he said, in order to have. And lo and behold, Andy from Keyport. Set one aside for me. I'm like, oh my god. It's the only thing he's ever set aside for me. No, take that back. He's been nice a few times. I'm not even sure what I'd have as a wash up to that. Poco, not Matt or Miles. Nice. J-Dog, there. Cobra says, hello there. J-Dog says, General Kenobi. Chuck says, I hope the ham made it there on time. Or in time.
Speaking of which.
No, it didn't. Yeah, I'll have to try some. Ike was pretty happy with it. Poco says, J-Dog, here at work. Poco, Christmas sucks. Cheers. Paul at PA Bruno says, cheers everyone, and
Macho Biden! Macho Biden! Macho Biden!
What the hell? Okay.
Now the hat's on Scooby, and the
what fell?
The phaser. Oh. I don't understand how, though. It's like pinned in there.
I had no idea.
Yeah, this is where I had it. As a matter of fact, I thought the shot glass was... I guess it must be angled a little bit this way. What I need to do is just put a little piece of tape under the bottom of the base of the one phaser, and so it sticks to the top of the other one. Put a World War II hat on Spock. Redneck says, Captain, my Captain, Merry Christmas to you, sir. Merry Christmas to you, too. Mike says, cheers, man. Then he says, J-Dog in the effing house. Awesome. Then he says, my dad has to stay in the hospital till Monday the 26th. So that means you should be taking him home today, hopefully.
Christine doesn't drink stouts, does she?
She doesn't drink beer.
This isn't beer.
For her, this is on the ickiest of them all list. I have seen, you know, I have seen her drink Canadian. Some Molson Canadian, because it fucking said Canadian on it. I'm like, come on, give me a break. You're willing to drink one of the shittiest beers that money can buy, next to PBR, all because it says Canadian on it.
So is the ham cut up, or is it still in a giant ham?
It's in a chunk.
Oh, I think ham would probably ruin this experience.
There's always Spam.
That would really ruin this experience.
So what do you want, caviar?
Caviar would ruin this fucking experience.
You know...
Hell, sex with my wife wouldn't ruin this experience.
You know, though, a scotch or a bourbon or a whiskey, I hate to say it, but it's almost more of a bourbon.
In this?
Not in it, to have if you're gonna...
Well, I think this stuff...
I am getting a subtle whiskey, though.
Aging in bourbon barrels.
The thing is over the years I've always said it's such a joke because it says bourbon. How many of these people said bourbon barrels, but they had never ever had bourbon in them? It was just a bourbon barrel.
So the bourbon barrels, actually, because they're toasted inside, that is what actually gives the bourbon its flavor. So you're getting a toasted oak flavor in it.
But with something like this, would the end result be better if they used a new bourbon barrel, or if they used one that had already had bourbon in it?
Yeah, a virgin or a one that's been bourboned, where the alcohol from the bourbon has soaked into the wood.
Mm-hmm.
Be interesting to see the difference.
There's only been a few times that I've actually ever had one that said aged in bourbon barrels, and then they said what bourbon barrels they were, and when you actually drank it, you definitely... It's like right now, if I added a quarter of a shot to yours, it was like the same experience.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if there's much that can make that better.
No, I wouldn't mess around with this.
No. I would definitely go bankrupt going and buying two more bottles, though. And you know what the best part of this is, Eric? I got to drink it before Jeremy brought over a bottle and drank it, and I thought it was his. I thought he drank mine.
No, your comment earlier before the camera was on was much funnier.
Oh, then
let's open this and drink it before fucking Jeremy gets here.
Now, you know what? We actually need one for when Jeremy gets here, though. We really do.
No, fuck him.
He can go buy his own.
Yeah, buy your own.
Buy your own and bring it up. Bring two of them.
Oh. You know, here's what's going to happen. I could take a piece of paper right now and write a couple of names on it as my guesses, and I would put a one most likely to hear from him, and... If I transfer some money to you, will you run and get me one of those?
You know who else would like this? Rich.
Thanks, you just blew it. That was number one on my list.
Well, I know Rich would thoroughly enjoy some of this.
I already have his box of bent paddle.
Mm-hmm.
Aging, waiting for him.
Yep. This...
Yeah, he's number one on my list of who I would think would be like, I gotta have me one of those. He might be able to find this, though. Toppling Goliath has a lot broader
distribution
than Ben Paddle. Ben Paddle is mostly local. I'm not even sure if you can get Ben Paddle in the cities yet.
I'm sure you can.
They have stepped
up. No, I've been into Total Wine, and they have it there.
In the cities?
In the cities.
Because I know they've been working harder and harder. I mean, you got to consider this. When Ben Paddle started, it was like me and you and a few pieces of brewing equipment.
Yeah. Wow.
Oh, he wasn't here, but when J-Dog decided to surprise me with a Christmas present from you know who you are, and you're awesome. And I was kind of bummed out because they only shipped it.
I didn't know that Santa Claus had his FFL.
Santa's cooler than you thought. I thought it only came with one mag.
I think he's got FFLs.
Take that back. I was bummed that it only came with one mag. But I was looking in the door of the safe, and evidently I hosed Mikey. My other gun either came with three, or it came with two, and Mikey only
May
got
I see
one
that
mag.
One? Does it have one in the chamber?
It does not. But I know you'll check it anyway.
Because safety. Ooh. That's nice.
That right now has to go down as the heaviest gun in my 1911 connect. Because
I would like to shoot this.
I bet you this weighs as much as this.
That's very comfortable in the hand.
It'd be great someday is to actually go through the BS and get the can for it.
Or just get the can and not actually put it on video.
Well, come on. I would never think about that.
I need to wipe my frickin' hand juice off of it.
Well, I tried a new product on here, and I'm not quite sure about it. But it's supposed to leave a residue behind that gets down into the gun. But when you combine 16 rounds of ammo.
Hey, Eric, I got a question for you. Huh? What if we just took and got a little tiny fuel filter or a oil filter and made a adapter?
These are things we don't discuss.
I mean, what things?
The mirror. Don't have balls to scratch my gun. The mere mention of what you're talking about.
I mean, I've seen it done. I wouldn't actually do it. But.
Oh, I would never do it. But to answer your question, if you were to put an oil filter onto something like that, it would make it quieter than the $1,000 can and the $200 bullshit begging the government, can I have it? I mean, that's what Rob told me, anyway. A friend of mine, I'm not saying it was me, a friend of mine has experimented with various things. And a frickin' high-quality Fram oil filter is quieter than a $1,000 suppressor.
The only thing I would be worried about is if the filter media started to disintegrate.
It does.
Then you start to get stuff pulled back in the barrel?
It does. Can you believe that the pulse rate is so fast that it can actually suck debris out of the filter, down the barrel, and trap it between the bolt lugs and the bolt, and make it so the gun is locked?
Yep, I believe it. Well, you know the Abrams tank, that big bulge in the middle of the barrel? That's a fume extractor. So as the round fires, that fills up with gas before the round is expelled from the tube, and it pressurizes that. It's like an inch thick fiberglass or carbon fiber, whatever the hell they use. It actually is so much pressure it expands it, and then there's holes drilled at an angle down towards the exit of the barrel. Mm-hmm. And so it pressurizes that, and when the round leaves the tube, it actually pushes fumes out, and as it does, it extracts fumes from the inside of the rest of the tube.
Wow. That's a whole different level of holy shit, though, isn't
it? So if you took and you built a fume extractor for a rifle, is it Is it a fume extractor?
All I know is, I thought, I mean, my friend thought that.
Hey, you know something else, Eric?
Wow, that's like the frickin' promised land right there.
This is essentially a 30 proof, isn't it? 15 ABV?
Mm-hmm.
It's a 31 proof. If I drank this much 30 proof liquor, I'd feel weird right now.
Yeah, this is like the equivalent to a weak shot.
Schnapps. 24? But if I drank this much schnapps,
yeah, my friend, when that happened, his buddy, and I'll change the names to protect the innocent, my friend's buddy Blob, was pushing down as hard as he could on one side of the charging handle. Well, my friend, who will rename nameless, was hitting the other side of the charging handle with a dead blow hammer. And I was like, he was like, this is it. And $89 charging handle is going to get broken, but it finally, and it was just a little chunk.
It doesn't take
of the
much.
Element.
If it doesn't, it doesn't take much when it's that tight of a tolerance in the first place.
But now, if you just use it for, let's just stay with the storyline that these losers that are trying to control the narrative, in other words, the un-Second Amendment people. I personally think every single person that stands against the Second Amendment does not deserve to have a role in our government. But yeah, I think they pretty much assume that you just screw this thing on there, one
and
shot and you're
it,
done.
Makes it quiet, makes it silent. It's what? How many fucking responsible gun owners go out and would put something like that on a weapon, say go shoot another person? Really, think about it. And it's people who are mentally ill who would think that that would be the use for that.
Well, look at that last shooter. He had weapons and ammunition that me and you cannot afford, and he didn't have a fucking job. I'd like someone to explain that all to me.
Well, shit, Eric, you know why I'm buying all this shit? The camper and everything? I just keep making up different IDs. Then I'm going to go out and shoot someone, and the FBI keeps putting money in my account. I don't understand it. They haven't cut on yet.
After all, that right there, that's a fuel filter.
Yeah. I don't even know what the fuck that would be. That's a fucking flashlight, Eric. That's a mag light.
It's bigger than a D-mag light. But actually, if you can, well, maybe not anymore. They probably have all been taken down. But there's a lot of videos out there for converting a mag light into a can. I mean, companies sell the ends for it. Mike, both Miles and Matt in the local in the Kibasa. Just saying, but I do like both kids. You're liked.
I know I'm liked.
Mike again.
Except for my smile money.
I need more 10mm ammo and guns, but lack of money is a problem. Mike, I agree. I am, I was supposed to be on a spending freeze, but I've been egging Jay at Elite Ammunition now for years to sell me this, and he finally did, and I really look forward to shooting this. No, in my world, it has been one incredible Christmas, and everything was a 10mm. The Kimber Raptor, the 2011 Rock Tac Double Stack, and the SIG Mauser M2.
So it's not a can, it's nothing illegal. You need to find someone who can take a 10mm socket and bore it out and thread it so you can put it on the end of that fucker.
That's not illegal.
That would be fucking cool as shit, dude. Wouldn't it?
Yeah, the other thing we were hoping was the right thread, but it's not.
Hey, Eric, this... let me see something. That would be awfully thin. May I? Mm-hmm. It would be awfully thin. And it would be... Or you'd have to make it so it has a small knurl on it, so it makes it extended. But you could make a threaded adapter for this, because this, being larger than this, you'd have to have it, you know what, you just need to have John make another one of these.
Oh, he could make that pitch. All I have to do is tell him what I want for a thread. Oh,
I did machining for a long goddamn time, Eric. Hang on.
Partially catching on.
Yeah, it's because it's cocked in there, but you'd also have to take and drill it out. But
that's the other problem. Oh, look, it's a 10 millimeter holder. See, this is an example of why I'm pissed. I polished this up for Jim, as in Matt's friend, and it's rusting.
Is that stainless or is that just steel?
Must be. It has to be steel. I thought it was stainless. If the world was perfect, you could shoot a 10 millimeter through a 308, a 30 cal, but the tolerance is way too close.
Shit goes wrong, and it's like that guy firing the slap T through a 50 cal with a break.
That would be terrible.
This would be easy to take. Well, maybe not now. You'd have to check.
Did I even finish my story?
No, you didn't. I interrupted.
The gun only came with one mag, and I was bummed because you should have all mags, but you should have at least two so you can shoot and move, you know, that kind of thing. And I opened up the safe door, and I found the one that's in the gun right now fully loaded. So my other gun must have come with three mags, or I screwed Mikey and he only got one mag. And I'm not apologetic because... For me, especially on a gun that I would consider carrying, you have to A, have a holster, and B, I'd like to have at least four mags.
Mm-hmm. You know what would be kind of cool, Eric?
Her sitting on my face.
That would be very cool. Actually, it'd be kind of warm. No, if you took and you made like a pop-up style range, like the military has, so you got a lane, you walk down, you make little plywood man targets. And just for fun at a shoot, you walk down or you get the full 300-yard thing where it's popping up.
And walk 300 yards?
No. That's a fixed position. So you're sitting either in a foxhole or the prone position. And then you got to try and shoot it and score it.
EMT Railfan, Merry Christmas to the B&E Captain Dick Nozzle 10mm Bullet Crew. Got them all covered in there. Oh, and by the way, we need to have a little drawing. I know Miles does not like the Millennium mug. So we have... Uh-oh. We're already losing people. We have Gun Wild 1. Guess that's appropriate. Gunwild 1, EMT, well here, I have to do it in this order so it doesn't sound like he's got as many, EMT, Sharky, EMT, and I have added a few items. You will get to pick from one of these items, it's got a laser, the original candle lantern, a fast-acting big-ass towel, or this flashlight. And even though it doesn't look like that picture, I like this flashlight because when you press the button, it turns on.
And save on shipping, you can give it to me.
There's no... And to save on shipping, you can just give it to Miles. Okay, so the candle thingy is no longer an option. Just kidding.
Okay. What's that?
That was the bottom row. That would have been contestant number 6. Miles! You lost one! That's blank.
It's the... So then it would go to my wife.
What? Am I picking her?
I will explain to you later.
There's a shock. He had 3 of them in there. EMT, when you got it on the little boat. So you have your choice of the laser, the flashlight,
you know what?
The towel, or
we can't,
the...
Yeah. Here, throw it in here. That's good, though.
You're still not as tall as J-Dog.
No shit.
Almost. Yeah, you're as tall as J-Dog.
Yeah. It's a lot more comfortable since I cut the ridge out of it.
Crazy 8 moonshiners.
I wonder how pissed off my dogs would be if I wore the shit in the house.
I'm guessing that's Wayne. Wayne, I love you, bro. Not, I don't love you as much as that badass. Mike, I can't wait till I get my brand new Gen 5 Glock MOS. And a Stoeger P3000 28-inch shotgun out of Hawk, a.k.a. Layaway. I was disappointed. J-Dog informed me that Layaway is only 60 days over at the other place. I mean, it's cool that you got 60 days, but... Actually, I shouldn't bitch because I don't know how many times I've had something on Layaway... And as soon as they called and told me that it was physically at the store, that is about when I went and picked it up. Or if you put something on layaway, I make one payment, and the next time I get a check, I stand on the corner with my cardboard sign until I have enough to go back to the store to pick it up. Mike Moore says, cheers and Merry Christmas, everyone. Merry Christmas, Mike. Back to the other Mike. If you show Jim anything Smith & Wesson, he gets a boner big time. Just saying. Yes, he does.
Yeah, Eric, it's still not coming back up. Or if it is, it's just barely.
That's because it's too heavy. It just got stuck.
I'll bet you if I farted, it didn't smell like that.
Salty. I naked, you naked, we all naked. And Cobra... has a something.
What the fuck? Oh, it's a. Looks like something doing this.
Mike! Damn, J-Dog! Where's my Christmas gift? Just kidding, very awesome. Mike, again, I sure wish something good would go good for me this year or next. Yeah, that's. Be nice if something went good for, all of us. Gunwild? Damn! Nice gifts, J-Dog. Gunwild? I hope you gave J-Dog at least a reach around for that gift. A rusty trombone would be even better. We made him dinner. Oh my god, that was so frickin' awesome. I am definitely doing it again.
Making dinner for J-Dog?
Bought a almost a 2-inch thick family steak. From Superior Meats, and sliced it the long way so it looked like a whole pile of tongues, and then put it in the pressure cooker along with green pepper and onion and sauteed everything for about 10 minutes, and then I added some seasoning in there, but nothing real heavy, and then I cooked that all up and put it on toasted butter and mozzarella buns, hoagie buns. Oh my god, that was incredible. Mr. 27 says top 32nd. Gunwild says Charlie 4. We're already into it. C4. C4 is a miss. DFC, J Dogs, a meat gazer. I don't know if that sounds good. Cobra, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas, Cobra. Matt Davis, Mark Subaru was on Fox News with his Buttmaster. Yeah, that's been put on the list that you can no longer own in Canada. But then again, Canada has basically banned almost everything.
Are you gonna ban rocks and sticks next?
Cheap old gun guy, wishing you and yours a very Merry Christmas. Oh, by the way.
This stuff is fabulous.
Yeah.
Eric.
Jim, Hornet Fixer. 1 hour, 46 minutes, and 19 seconds. Ain't got time for that. I'm assuming you're talking, I think that's the whole shit and show. Yeah. Yeah, baby. Jim, the new MMP medal competition is on my must-have list, as well as the PC Shield 9 Plus. And they have teased me with a picture of a 5.7 by 28 MMP 2.0 in a gas cabinet.
In a gun cabinet survey.
Do not tease me. Tease my addiction, Smith & Wesson. No fucking way. A Model 12. Discontinued in 1986, aka a 38 MMP airweight. Only 4 engineering changes. Love the Rock Island threaded barrel, 1911. Eric, congrats. Jim, we enjoy J-Dog better than the M&M show. Laugh out loud. That's only because you see J-Dog. What is it? How has it been? How many months?
Hear him. You see him and you don't hear him.
Jim, my 45 can shoot, be here in January.
Should be there in January.
Which will also do a 10 millimeter. Oh, 45 can. Yeah. I'm eventually going to have to go the legal route, but I don't want to. I so adamantly disagree.
So once you get the authorization for one can you buy all the cans you want?
Nope, you have to beg them for every one.
What if you got one and just had it so it fit a bunch of shit?
You can. Yeah, the can is serialized. You can do whatever you want with it. That's why the smartest move is to get a can in 45 ACP, because you can shoot everything through it then. It's not as effective for 22, but you can still put it on a 22. And that's exactly what I do, but then again, I want my first suppressed gun to be the Glock. But the only gun that I presently own that has a threaded barrel. So now, the problem is, here's what the problem is. I don't have to go buy special ammunition for a 45. I have to go have special ammunition for that in order to take advantage of the can. Because 45 ACP is already traveling subsonic.
So if you don't have a subsonic round, then the can is ineffective?
No, it's still...
Or less than effective?
Well, very, yeah. There's such a difference between shooting, say, two of them side by side, like a 9mm and a 45.
But the subsonic is already going to be quieter.
Yeah. So, if you want to shoot anything through anything, you have to get subsonic ammunition. Unless it's a 45, because it already came that way.
It's more effective that way, but you could shoot
Yeah.
You know, you almost had it where you didn't even react to that.
Until my eyebrows burnt off, yeah. Jim. Sharky, cheers all. Hi, J-Dog. Tons of Smith & Wesson's out to play. What I'll probably do for the next brewery review is once again see if I can find all of the 10 millimeters in the house, and the collection has substantially grown. Remember the last time I went and found them all and laid them on the counter and took a picture? I realized that after I might have uploaded it to Fagbook or something like that, but I had forgotten about the Blackhawk.
You're going to need a bigger counter, Eric. We're going to clean this one.
I don't consider that a problem.
I don't know if it's because you're reading comments, but I know we had roughly the same amount.
I just can't. I can't yippee-ki-yay through this. By the way, guess what me and J-Dog and Christine did on Christmas Eve? Watched fucking Die Hard. Christine goes, this is not a Christmas movie.
I thought
J-Dog was going to come off the couch and beat her with a pillow.
Another stealth Christmas movie? Ooh. Is the Lord of the Rings series. It has elves.
Jeremy, thread pitch for a 45 is normally 5.78x28. I have no idea what the thread pitch on that is. I know it's cool as fuck. Sharky, damn, J-Dog. You're way too good for this world. Sharky, laugh out loud. Record territory, 47-12. I don't really want
to. You're gonna have to like cut a hole in the floor here for J-Dog to stand, so he's like the same height as you.
Yeah, she's pretty awesome there, Sharky. Yeah, J-Dog have to have a pit. The J-Dog pit. Please, okay. I thought for a minute I deleted the wrong window. The first comment is about to be read. Hell, I didn't even notice the time passing. Also, helps, I'm cooking stuff that takes time, read more button, and I have beer. Excellent. She's also a personal favorite. I'd love to see her run a marathon. Sharky, when you guys are digging through the drawer, I was waiting for a giant rock to roll in. Sharky, hour 4 and 40. Yeah, I agree with J-Dog. Those Glock shovels are pretty damn good. Also, perfect babe. I don't really get into that whole. I like the nipple, though. I don't really like tattoos on women either. So... to hit that again. Did I get there? Was I squirreled? Oh no. Yeah, there's Chris, we haven't done a shot. We haven't got to the backup beer.
I don't think we're gonna need to. We should not get to the backup beer today.
Besides that, since I saw you last, I think I'm 4 deep into pre-gaming.
Yeah, we don't need to go any further.
No shots though. I was thinking about doing a shot of scotch too, before this. I don't know now.
No, I don't know what I can do now. I this anything I eat now would ruin this experience.
Sharky says, J-Dog, talk all you want when you're over there. You don't interrupt others. Sharky?
Got something in my eye.
Goddamn. Sharky, laugh out loud. I have the Raja 3. Those Leatherman shears cut through anything people will be wearing or caught in. In a car, my fireman mate has been using one of those for years now, and it hasn't failed him. Sharky SH, and of course, robbery. Damn it. I don't remember what I use, but I'll figure it out and use her again. Din Scourge, we can all agree at least the guests are better than Chuckles. Laugh out loud. I don't know if I'd be pissed about that or not. Din Scourge, take a schwat. Okay.
Here.
I'd love some.
Here, did you?
Okay, so. There might have been alcohol involved. Go over on your side. It was C4. It was the same as explosives. Well, yeah, technically, they're all hit. They're all explosions, right?
They're only all hits on my board.
It was the invisible ship, C4. Okay, wrong peg. Oh. I was going to say, maybe we're in record territory, but we're not. Mr. Mark Mac 85, Merry Christmas, Eric and J-Dog. Poco, I don't care what you say. I'm not a fan of the forward grip, even though I've left it on there. Otherwise, I keep getting schooled by you. And last in 13 hours ago was my man Zippy9898. And he says, Merry Christmas, y'all. Merry Christmas, Zippy. We've already given our score of 21 on a scale of 1 to 10 for this. So, moving on to the club. Must have forgot to hit his. The only person in the club is Rich. And he says, cheers, clubbers. Boom. Okay.
If we had another one of those, I would probably start drinking it.
No, you wouldn't. I'd hit you with the mallet and you'd just wake up next to your garage.
It's a sore ass.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't think
backup is not necessary. So I went and bought myself a new drill today, Eric.
Today?
Today. The old one, the chuck was chewing up bits and was making winding and grinding noises as I'm trying to drill through stuff. So.
How old's the other one?
6 years now. At least. I bought it while working at my last job. And I've been with Phil's over 5 years, so.
Really, it's been that long. Since I got free beer. Mm-hmm. Or well discounted beer anyway. Come on over, bring the truck. Remember that shoot that year? I finally just had to give in and take all the racks out of the refrigerator because all it was doing was bending them.
I think I'm in a better place now though, Eric.
Booze, garage doors. Booze.
I can afford more booze now than I can get for free there.
No, that's true. Still know anybody that would, I think they turn over people fast.
Yep.
Okay, I'm gonna hit the button, and then I'm getting out of here. The only thing I have to do is, technically I have to, edit the, Crate Club video. And I have to edit this, and then Christine wants to get back to Witcher. blood origin. But if I was to put a couple of movie recommendations out there, I thought This Is War. I think it was This Is War. And it had, what's his name from Star Trek, played Captain Kirk, the new guy, Chris Pine. Chris Pine was in it, and I thought it was worthwhile. It was basically an action comedy romance, and I thought it was well done instead of just corny. And I highly recommend the Glass Onion, Knives Out. But if you are like my Lily, me and Christine were telling her it's a must-watch, she informed me that this is actually the second movie, and they have announced that they're going to be making a third, and I didn't even know that the first one was out there. And it's one of those deals where it has everybody that is acting in it is famous from somewhere else. It's just it was a great movie, a murder mystery with some nice twists and surprises. But now I need to try to find the first one, and when Lily did a search for it, it was available nowhere for free. But
I'll bet you it is.
But she did find it on the Red.
On Rob's little freaking secret source.
Yeah.
If you want computer viruses on your shit.
I already forgot what the second name was. I only remember the first half because it's the same as one of my favorite motorcycles. This one.
Movies.
FZ Movies?
Yes, FZ Movies.
Probably find it there, yeah. Okay, then Scourge, when I refreshed, he says, No Shot Club, ? Now I'm going to do one more time.
No shots are necessary with this.
I'm going to have to go squeegee these glasses off, for God's sakes, look at that. Wicked. Okay. Cheers, guys, and I hope everybody had a Merry Christmas and a good time, and we will see you...